What in the world is this music? This is horrible.
Oh my gosh. We're gonna change this music.
Hey everyone. Starting a little late. Chaos. Abort is just chaos. Let's try.
Oh my gosh, that was horrible.
Put that down.
Get some ZBrush up and going.
Sorry. Chaos tonight. Woo! Hey guys, I made it! We're here. Boy, do I have a story for you guys.
What? Let's see. What was I working on? JK. Secret.
Okay, we're here. We're doing this.
Hi, everybody.
Is that a dying radio? Yeah, that music was horrible. We're just going to have that, like, as background as possible. The sound's not going to be great. I don't know if I can change the sound right now. Hold on. Da-dun-da-dun. Is that sound too loud? Well, it sounds like it's a little too loud. Okay, this may kill everything. Just trying to check the sound, get the sound all geared up and going. Okay, let's see here. And I press the kill all. Ah! Zing! Hey, how's it going, Expecto? I don't know if that sounds any better or not. Trying to change a few settings, streaming settings. Let me know if it sounds like poop. There's nothing I'm gonna do about it. How's it going, everybody? So to get going on this, for those of you who haven't joined in from the last one, oh, how's it going, gamer? First one, Xenos Fighter, nice. Hey, Kingsley. Woo! Sounds better? Does it sound better? Good. I'm trying to get rid of, like, the crackling that it had. Dark and Grim, how's it going? Okay. So, close that. So this is, to pick up where we were last week, is this is a crocodile that I'm trying to, the whole goal of this is to kind of create something really dynamic, really, hey Christopher, your voice is fine, but the music stutters. Let's try to turn on that music. For some reason it's like super loud on the music. Is that any better? I'm guessing it's maybe a little bit better. It's looking better on my end. Okay, let's try that. If it's too loud, let me know. The background music, it's just there to be background music. It's not supposed to be good. The noise canceling thingy. Let's see.
Oh, my mic has the dip. The
how do I stop that? Try to fix this on. This isn't gonna happen. I'll try to fix that. Anyways, okay. Just some technical difficulties. I ordered a computer today, or I didn't. Or I ordered it a couple days ago, a few days ago. I'm building my own PC, and it was delivered today, and it was. Hold on, yes.
You finished Last Ninja Go.
Start something else.
We're gonna start this a different thing, but we're gonna get off something that we do that we watch that we know.
Okay, good. Sorry about that. It's probably just a Mac thing. Yes. So I'm trying to get out of the world of the Mac. This is the technical difficulties. So I ordered this awesome new computer that's going to change my life for the better. And, you know, a billion times faster than this piece of crap. And it was all supposed to be delivered, all the parts. I'm building it myself. So I ordered all these parts. It says delivered like 30 minutes before I get home. 30 minutes before I get home. I get home and nothing is on my porch. Not a single package, not a single. I'm supposed to have like 7 different packages filled with all this stuff and not a freaking thing. And so there's just chaos ensues, and so we'll get it taken care of. Amazon's great. Luckily I ordered everything off Amazon. Well, hopefully it'll be great. I don't know if it'll be great. I'm hoping to hope that everything will be great. And once it is built, it'll be a beast of a machine, which is great. Thank you, Kingsley. We'll fix that on my next stream. You're the man. So I'm super like paranoid right now. So if at the beginning I'm like super hyper and like a little like anxious, that is why. Okay, so CPU overload. Ha ha ha, yes. Yes. See, I have that Pixel Desire actually. Like I do have that, and I was notified that it was delivered, and 30 minutes later I get home and it's gone. Completely gone. And we couldn't be out. We were also we were out watching my son wrestle. He's doing this little like preschool wrestling meet, and so we watched that, which was a lot of fun. It'll be okay. Everything in the universe is okay. Okay. So now back to this dude. What we're gonna do is we're gonna try to finish him off as much as we can today. The big things are his hands kind of in place. They're all separate pieces. We want this guy to be printed in the end, 3D printed. So we're going to try to make him, we're going to think about that some, but not so much that it's affecting the overall design. What is a Kuna? Yay! Hey, Stadius. Yeah, I ordered the i7-7700K and a 1080, yes. But I've also ordered the new AMD 1800X, which is a 8-core instead of a 4-quad-core. It's slightly slower, but everything is 8-core instead of a quad-core, and it maxes out even better, and you know, I've pre-ordered that as well. So we're going to do some mix and matching, and I'm going to look at this link from Pixel here. It's probably like, yes, of course. Yeah, I could definitely use that. I'm so like, right now I'm just so mad that someone would do that, that like someone would just, basically, they were following the truck, is how much. Or it was one of my neighbors, which I doubt it was, because I live next to a bunch of old people. But, man, I'm frustrated. That just bugs me so much. I'm going to have to get that pixel. I think you're right. So, back to ZBrush, because ZBrush is our friend, and we love... I don't know what you want, what you got, Expecto. Yeah, I know. I've thought about doing a dual Xeon models, actually, but I'm actually decided to do a beast of a machine, and then I'm going to build a rendering machine later with dual Xeon machines or Xeon cores or Xeon processors, and just have that strictly for rendering. And I'll try to max that out at like 60 or 36 cores for that one. Get to 16 core machines. Anyways, oh cool. So, yay! Here we go. Now that I'm gonna try to calm down, and great, let's do this. Let me know if you guys have any questions along the way as I'm doing this. I'm just going to jump in with the arm and dynamesh this and just kind of finish it off. Let's see. Da-da-da-da-da. Save room for heating bills. Yes, the 1080 is a thing of beauty, which I love. Which I'm going to love. It should have been here today. And I was going to love it. And I was just going to show you all these parts that I had. And boy, did I buy like a bunch of LEDs as well. I bought a ton of LEDs. And I'm going to make that thing glow like it's Christmas. Just looking up some reference before I dive too much into this. That's kind of fun. Okay, let's do it! What do the 77s go for? I think they go for like $350. $350 is the going price for the 77s. And the 1800X, the Ryzen, is $500 right now. So, and that's their top line of the three processors that they released. So, okay, so let's just dive into this now. We've got multiple parts. Feel free to ask questions as we're going along. I'll try to keep myself together. I want to give like more meat to this hand. Have it really feel like it's kind of squishing. Yeah, I think Intel's probably going to drop their prices quite a bit because that Ryzen processor is like half the price, and it kills, like, it does just as good as that Intel, what is it, 69K, which I was looking into as well, but it just didn't seem worth it for the price of, like, the amount that you're getting out of it. Okay, let's dynamesh this sucker together, and just have some fun sculpting.
love using the Dynamesh Master that Joseph Drust and I can't remember who he did it with, made this plugin. Still, like I'm going, that's really high. Going from like 3,000 total for this arm to like this arm's like so low. Awesome. Okay. he's probably not going to wear jeans. How am I going to work the legs into the body? Really? Ooh, let's take off. I've got all your mask on. The legs probably aren't going to actually work in, or they're not going to have jeans. I think he's just going to be a desnudo croc. A naked croc. I'm going to kind of sculpt them out individually. Like, I'll sculpt this arm, and then I'll mirror it, kind of match what I did over here. And then I'll sculpt the leg, and then dupe it over here, and then I'll Dynamesh all these together, is the idea for right now. I might keep them separate so I can put keys in there, so they can actually print individually as I'm printing this, and it will be, you know, a bunch of key pieces, and we'll just knock them in together. Here's how you work the legs into the body of the croc with these jeans. Well, he's got to stop eating his carbs. Or maybe all carbs. Like, what do you... He's got to eat more protein, less protein. Something like that. What are the fun... And I like doing, like, kind of this manual smooth after, like, you probably get away with doing a polish. But I like kind of having control of where, how I'm polishing things. You can do carbs on workout day. Yeah, he'll just do carbs on workout day. Sometimes for big creases, I just like to go in with the orb crack brush. Kind of cut that in, really, you know, make that really apparent. Smooth it out just a titch. Let's change my smooth. Back to the regular smooth. Just smooth it out a little bit. And then go in with the inflate. Just inflate it a little bit, and it brings those things together. Get really nice creases that way. What I've started to do with butts a lot, actually, is like cutting them in really hard. It's going to sound real gross. And then using that inflate to kind of bring them together. And then kind of pinch off the ends. Oops. Whoa. You can hear my computer. Oh, the stroke is... No, I just... It's really, like, low. I'm the classic noodler, and I like to keep things super low. Like, this whole thing, even with this Dynamesh up to 80,000, the whole thing's only at 420, 430. Like, it's still super low, so just the way I like to keep it. You know, and then kind of keep the idea that I'm going to do stylized crocodile anatomy that's more or less mimicking human anatomy. Am I going to print it solid or in parts? This one, I'm going to do two tests. I'm going to do one with it printed solid. The thing, if you print it solid, because this has so many overhangs, is you're going to get supports everywhere. Like, look at this. Look at this dude. He's going to have supports going from his belly to his gullet up there to his chin. Supports hanging off everything. So that's probably not going to look great and probably require a fair amount of cleanup. So what I'm going to do instead is try to work it out where I have keys in the arms, probably the head I'll print separate, and the legs and the skateboard. So that way I kind of so that way I have great control over like where the supports are going to be printed, like, and this I know most people are going to see it from the top, so I don't want supports here, and I could print it almost completely sideways and just have a few supports on the arm and the fingers. Will I be showing you how to create the keys? I bet we could find time to create the keys tonight. If I don't create them this week, I'll show you next week. Keys are real simple in ZBrush with Dynamesh and you know, just extracting and you know, it's real, real simple. We did it. I mean, that's how we did the keys actually for everything and for prototyping for Disney Infinity as well. Can you put keys in Simplify 3D? I've heard of Simplify 3D, though I've never really used it. There's a lot of programs I've never used that I'm sure would make my life better. But I know ZBrush so well that it's hard to like say, oh, I'll learn this package and do it, but I'm sure it's awesome. The new Ultimate Maker 3. Oh yeah, I saw that. The new Ultimate Maker 3 actually looks pretty cool. It's expansive for what it is. I mean, it's probably a great printer. I mean, it is a great printer. The Ultimate Maker has always made great printers, but it is expensive. Like, when you think you can get the form for that same price, though the cost per print is way higher on the form, too. So I understand why you wouldn't. I'll kind of see what details I want to push. After going through 16 hours of math tutorials. Thanks for checking out my tutorials. Try not to leave anything out. And it just got quiet. You might hear some stomping around. My kids are being put to bed. I was supposed to have the kids to bed before I started the stream, but then I believe all my packages got stolen. So, as happy as I am for that, but I've already called Amazon. They're going to hook me up. Well, I really hope so. If not, I'm screwed. Ah! What happened to the Nightbot? He was so nice to us. Thanks, Zanbot. I'm gonna give some squish to those hands, just a little bit more. I kind of bulging out this area a little bit. I don't want so hard because it's two hard angles together, like a hard here and a hard here. It's just gonna look more robotic than anything else. So I'm gonna try to soften it up by build it up with just the clay build up brush. There's Nightbot! Oh, thank goodness. He still lives! I love you, Nightbot. Squish there, start pushing some of these shapes out a little bit more, like really exaggerate this elbow. Have it roll forward just a little bit. Let's go ahead. Start a new page of music, Muzak. It did it. I'm just kind of checking out the details from like far away. This is going to be printed. It's only going to be, I think max is 6 inches. So that's probably the size. and to build up some of this like shoulder muscle and kind of hint that there will be a clavicle be, you know, there. Not a clavicle, a scapula. I'm going to take a break for like 2 seconds. My wife, I need to tell my wife that's going. I'm going to answer your question in just a second. Yeah, just a second. I'm going to put this on pause.
Hello, Internet.
Be back in less than 5 minutes. And we're back! Sorry, just filling in the wife on the status of package gate. Where my new computer is. And I forgot. Aha! It's in its case. I never put the pen. I never do this. And I did it. And that's where it was. Anyways, yeah, Pixel is right. I am getting the Prusa MK2. Is the resin chip... So I don't think it's set up to do dual yet. There's very actually few motherboards that support, or that right now that support the resin, or the Ryzen chip. So I found one that will support it. That I've pre-ordered, and that should come next week, ideally. And so I'm hoping, like, eventually it will. Like, I'm not super concerned. It's with the Ryzen chip. That'll be enough for, you know, KeyShot to handle really well. My renders. I mean, my renders are pretty robust for KeyShot, so I've found different ways to like try to simplify. But. And then I'll probably build that render machine, you know, for around, you know, $1,200-$1,300. Some guy, I follow these guys, that show some pretty simple steps on building like a 36 core Xeon machine. So I'll be doing that and just toss renders over, and then I'll be able to keep working. What's my reasoning for getting the Prusa? Okay, that is a great question. So I've been in the printer market for a long time, you know, looking at different printers. I've been on the edge of getting the Form printer, the Form 2, which is an excellent printer. I love the Form 2. But I, you know, cost per print, the Form 2 is pretty high for someone who's not doing a ton of printing or, you know, selling. Like, I will eventually start doing that. But initially, I'm just going to be doing a lot. I'll be doing a lot of prototypes. And for the price, the Prusa is the highest rated and the highest quality, even over the Maker, the Ultimate Maker 2, for quality and price. It's got a great price. It's got a decent quality, enough to get me what I want until I start wanting to do like final prototyping for some of the stuff that I'm doing. So it's going to be good enough. And that's really what I need right now. Eventually I'll probably get a Form printer when and if I start doing more stuff that I want to sell. But just for like, I want to make my characters and... That looks horrible. I don't like that at all. Mushy. You built your 32 kit setup for, or 32 for 1,000? You know, you gotta hook a brother up. Tell me, do you have a part picker? Do you have a part picker list of your setup? That'd be cool to see what you did to get that. Okay, Duke. Let's mirror this over to this side now. Let's do another save. I'm just looking at this computer real quick. There you go. Just a few of those. That's awesome. Saved. Okay, thank you. So you have... two of those chips? Or do you have a... Is there such a thing as a four-board motherboard? Or do you have two motherboards? Is that even possible? No, less of it.
Oh, thanks. So I'm going to Z-remesh this. So I've just Z-remeshed everything. Look at that beautiful topology in like 2 seconds. Deep this up and subdivide it up a little bit. Not too high. It doesn't need to be too high right now. And then just project all, and it will bake that high detail from, you know, this one onto it. Just like butter. That's great. Now, arm 01. Go ahead. Put everything back on that we need. Leggies, leggy, 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 blondie, 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 blondie. Okay, so let's turn off the high. So now when I mirror this, like it's, I got my subdivisions on it. So I can just mirror it. Do a save before we mirror. And I like to put them as a different subtool. Here's holding hands. Now I'm just going to place this kind of a starting point, and then I'll, you know, sculpt the symmetry out of it.
Ooh, pictures! Nice!
Sweet. Did you build that box yourself too? Sweet, man. I wish I had skills. Like real skills, like building like a boat. I want to be able to build a boat with my own two hands. Why can't I just build a boat? Maybe I'll 3D print a boat. I could 3D print a boat way better than I could build a boat. Interesting, like building this in asymmetry, like the measurements I had were pretty dead on, which is pretty great. Now the forearm in this one's a little bit bigger. That's okay. Twist that form a little bit.
Yeah, I believe that.
Instructables! Yes! Now I can build a boat!
That is awesome. See, the internet is great. This is what the internet's for. It's to be able to learn how to build a friggin' boat. I'm going to see if I like this twist in this one. I do not. Go back to just simple. Open it up a little bit. No, twist it up. The books of the future. So you decide to leave 3D modeling behind and start building things with your hands. You idiot! Let's do one of these. I'm not really sure what I was doing with this hand, but ooh, cancel. I'm just taking a screen grab of it so I could actually just put it together. I will do that. I'm putting this. See, that's the plan, is that I'm going to build one of these. Ooh, that's a beast of a machine. Just for rendering. And I love the idea of 40 threads. Like, initially I wanted this computer that was like 40 threads, 1080 card, like 900 billion gigs of RAM. And then I was like, oh, yeah, I don't have $1 billion. So, kind of worked it out that I could get what I wanted in two machines instead of trying to just wham it all into one for cheaper.
Yes, I want 112 threads. Oh, only for 40. Okay, then I'll be fine because with my boat making skills, I'll just be able to make that back. That 40 grand with my boat making skills. Hey, how's it going, Kyle? I think Kingsley's here. He helped us out. I don't know if he is, but I'm sure he is in spirit, if anything else. He was here earlier. You missed me regaling everyone about how I ordered this awesome new computer and all the parts were supposed to arrive today and they were stolen from my front porch. You're sculpting along with me! Yay! See, I knew Kingsley wouldn't leave me. Kingsley's too good of a guy to have done that to me. Kingsley, for example, wouldn't steal the package from my porch. Because he's that good of a guy. Now let's kind of fix some of this stuff that we've got going on. Now that we've positioned it, I'm just going to go in and kind of finesse the sculpt a little bit. Because now that he's pulling that finger back, I really want to emphasize that knuckle, or that meat fat. Look at that, that's fun stuff right there. Fix that. Yeah, it sucks, Kyle. I'm trying to work it out with Amazon right now. Tomorrow, we're hoping that it wasn't stolen and that it was just
delivering air as they delivered to the wrong house, or labeled it as delivered when it was not actually delivered. That's what we're hoping. So we'll find out more tomorrow, though it was a pretty specific time that it was said delivered, and it was the one time that we were not home. So, Morph. Maybe it was part of John Wick's crew that did it. And I want these fingers to feel fatty. Nice, Kingsley. Are you going to share with us? Yeah, that's what I'm kind of hoping is, like, without my signature, without any, like, visual confirmation that it was actually delivered. I mean, it was my... Everything was delivered today. Every single part of my setup was delivered today. Or was supposedly delivered today. So... I'm not really sure what to do. Other than spend the evening with you, fine people. Yes. Before ZBrush, nobody said nobody. Recall Flash. Aren't we all grateful for ZBrush and everything that it's made our lives better for? Okay, cool. Yes, you gotta share when you're finished. Okay. Probably okay with where that is ending up. Get a modified his shoulder meat. Like that, shoulder meat. You don't get to do shoulder meat on too many characters. Big, thick shoulder meat. Good for you. Low in carbs. And just little hints of, like, muscle right there. I like that. Ooh. Ooh. Again, kind of looking at it from a lot of different angles. It'll mostly be seen, like, on a desk. Like this. And this. I read those shapes really well.
Oh yeah? Can you say anything about your sculpt, Kingsley? I mean, Kingsley's gone. Kingsley's... We're forgetting about Kingsley until he comes back. I want to hear more about it. Is that what you guys do at Pixelogic all day? Is you just sculpt and you're like, oh, this is the greatest thing ever. I just get to sculpt whatever I want all day. I mean, that's kind of what I do, but I don't get to choose what I get to do. Most of the time. Some of the time. But, oh boy. Just fixing that camera a little bit. Or are you just trying to, at Pixelogic, are you just trying to make sure Paul doesn't burn down anything? Because I can see that being a real problem too. The cool thing about these legs is I'm not going to have to do too much to them to get them to where I want. Let me put... a little bit of detail in there where the patella that doesn't exist on a crocodile. And I'm going to thicken up these legs, so he's got kind of some thick ankles. So we're going to push really, kind of accentuate this outside curve. We've got nice, more or less straight on the inside. Woohoo! Calm down there. I'm going to put the arc of the curve of that thigh towards the top. And I can pull it in there. We get that nice... That's the technical term for it. And then beef up this ankle. These ankles have got to be thicker for printing purposes. And I like a good thick ankle. Moana was a lot of fun to sculpt for the toy sculpt. Because she had thick ankles. She had like tree trunks for legs. It was awesome. A lot of fun trying to like push that in the Disney Infinity style. Even though like the art director are like, oh no, you gotta make her thinner and more petite. I'm like, no, I'm not gonna do it. Screw you. And then he's like, okay. And then she was done. We'll send her to manufacturing. Yeah, we'll send her to manufacturing. Oh, by the way, I quit. It was basically the story of how it went. True story. Ah, yes. Oh, you have to do real work, Kyle. Of course.
We are super appreciative for that. This Pixelogic Live, though, like, it is just fountains of knowledge and talent going on all the time. So, this is great. Super happy to be a part of it.
Contraband.
I'm liking where that leg's going. Subdivide it up a little bit before we commit to anything.
She was my swan song? What was my swan song?
We're gonna give like subtle hints at like that knee is way wonky. I'm trying to give like subtle hints at anatomy, as this is more of a tubular character. But I still want like ideas of landmarks like the patella, I can't remember the something tubularosity, the tibia tubularosity is right here, and the right there, and then the tibial, the line of the tibula. I want all that in there subtly as just landmarks. And the reason why I have it in there is because it's just more relatable. It's, you know, you don't understand. They're most not, I say you. I mean, you. Oh, yeah, these live streams are awesome. But you get just little hints of realism in there. Even with a character like this, it just, you start relating to it. You're like, oh, yeah, I know what that is. Patella. Weird shape in there. So just like little hints of anatomy underneath the overall design. And then I want big sweeping curves. Like I don't want anything to feel mushy. Like it doesn't have a purpose. Like there isn't a flow to it. Yeah, I think Pixelogic has done such an awesome job with finding artists of such different backgrounds and styles and skill sets that, like, it makes these so much more interesting to watch, to, like, see, you know, someone working on rapid prototyping or more realistic things or more high-detailed things, or, you know, they're really quite awesome. Saving file.
Was this all from Z Spheres in the beginning, except maybe the head and board? Yes, everything was actually Z Spheres, even the head.
And it's just dynameshed into what I want. I think this is the original Z-Sphere from the original Z-Sphere. So it looked like this, but it had limbs. And this is a new technique that I'm trying to do, where I'm sculpting everything from asymmetrically. Normally I don't do this, and normally I don't recommend doing this. I just wanted to challenge myself to see if I could find more personality by doing this. You know, sculpting around, trying to find different curves, like give a little bit more uniqueness. And, you know, just to see what it would do. Normally I would sculpt this straight up, long tail, straight down, and then pose it after the thought, and then add the asymmetry after I've posed it. But this has kind of been a fun thing. Definitely a different process than I've done before. Yeah, no problem. Ooh, you know what I like? This. Oh, this is cool. I think I completely spaced this. Is this short? It goes from like a short thigh to a short calf. This one I've got almost too long. It's cool. I like the shapes that I'm pulling, but it's a little bit too long. Let's see if I can cut that back down, because I like that shape. Shrink, 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 shrink. We'll see how well this goes. Yeah, I like those short, how short that is. You can be more drastic with the heel and everything. Ooh, I like that. So that's what I'm saying is, like, happy mistakes of, like, you know, I mismeasured these calves for sure. But the idea that I can just, like, I found some pleasing shapes in the other one, so I can quickly, you know, go and match that shape. You know, and then maybe I'll end up liking this shape a little bit more, and then I can just mirror it over, not mirror it over, but something. It has nothing to do with this, but you struggle with neck pains too from working in the industry. That. Did you know that I actually do that? That I suffer from chronic migraines. Do you know that? Like syrup? Syrup. So yeah, I struggle with neck pain, mainly like right here, and it causes migraines. I get migraines like 3 or 4 times a week. And I've tried a number of things, actually. I'm going to take a 2-second break to grab something to show you what I'm trying, that I just got this. A package that wasn't stolen. Yeah, so I've tried a bunch of different things. I'll tell you what's worked and what hasn't worked. Let's just pause for 1 second. I'm going to keep the music on. I'll be back. I'm just going to grab something.
Dun 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 dun. And I'm back. Wrong image. Anyways, so I do. I struggle from, you know, I suffer from constant migraines. And mainly it's because of my bad posture. I've tried all different types of medications. Some that have really messed with my mind and I hated. Have I seen those desks that recline? Yes. The Wally desk, as I like to call it. And it's, I believe that I'm getting them because of bad posture. I have horrible posture. Something that I've really tried to work on. So I do some posture exercises where I kind of push my head into the ground. I go to a chiropractor. I've been going to a chiropractor for years. For the past 2 years, I've been going every other week consistently, and it's just still the same. It's kind of a struggle. I've tried a bunch of things, but mainly it's just my posture, I believe, that's the real culprit of all this. So I got this funky device, which you throw this around your back like so. Isn't this fun? This is educational. Then you wrap this around your knees, I believe, and this is the first time. This just came in the mail, so I haven't really even tried this out yet. You wrap those around your knees. That goes on the small of your back. And then I believe there's a clip. Look at that, there's a clip. You can't see this. So it wraps around your knees. This puts... Wow, that actually... And so then... You clip it together. I guess. The clip is broken! Well, we'll see. The clip is broken. Anyways, just having that is actually... Oh, yes. I've tried a standing desk. That didn't really help. This is supposed to help. It's supposed to help. I'll have to adjust these things to actually, like, get the support I need. But I have a lot of different things. I wear a back brace at work to help my posture. I do a lot of things, but it's mainly... When you have, like, my neck, I jut it forward. And when you have, when it's not stacked up properly, even like an inch forward is like double the amount of pressure you're getting from these muscles right here. And that's what's causing my migraines. Self-diagnosed. but I do lots of things. I've tried a bunch of different things. Chiropractic work. Botox injections, I've tried that. Pilates, I haven't tried Pilates. I've tried yoga. I've tried everything. I literally will try anything. There's a new one. Yes, Ashley's here. We can talk about conspiracies finally. There's a new one where you could, the rumor is that you can get right here pierced. Right there. It's called a daith piercing, which is supposed to help with migraines. I think it's probably hogwash, but honestly, like, if anyone's had migraines before, you will literally do anything to not get migraines. But I'm like 3 days without a migraine right now, which is awesome, which is super rare. But I just came off of like 7 days of straight migraines, so... Do I exercise? That's a personal question, Ronnie. Yes. I do some light exercising, and mainly like I do rock climbing quite a bit as well. But yes. So I've been following along and rendered out an image. Yes, critique time. Let's do it. Yeah. Yeah, this is great. Let's give her a critique of this. This is fantastic. Nerd. Yeah. We're all the same family. So I do exercise, probably not as much as I should, but I do rock climbing a few times a week during lunch. Is my story about my neck. And I do lots of different things. I even have this like weird compression thing, which helped for a while, and then it didn't help, so I don't do as much. And you're supposed to do it for like 20 minutes every day. And I have, if you check out my Instagram, I've got some pictures of me using this torture device, which helps sometimes and helps, it doesn't help sometimes. So I've done a lot of different things to try to make my neck feel better. Have you heard good things about the day? I'm convinced too. I'm like, I don't have any piercings. I don't have any tattoos. And I've never really thought about getting a piercing or a tattoo. But then I heard about this day piercing and I'm like, let's do it. Boom. Okay. Anything. And just nothing's really helped. I was on some, like, they put me on some seizure medication for a while. And literally, I couldn't even work. Like, it sucked all the creative thoughts out of my brain. Like, I remember sitting at a computer trying to draw, or sitting at a desk trying to draw, and I couldn't even think of anything to draw. I couldn't draw anything. It was just like, I could have no creative thought process when I was on that. And it didn't help the migraines. So, I got off that. Absolutely. Yeah, let's fix this knee again. Yeah, if I get it, everyone will know. You know, when you live in Utah and you live around a lot of people who don't believe men should have earrings. There's going to be lots of comments on it. But, again, I'd do anything. So, that's probably my next step, actually, is getting one of those. If this posture stuff doesn't work, it doesn't help. ZBrush is the only drug I need. Why are you called the Redbeard? I don't know why I'm called the Redbeard. I guess you can't really tell in this light. Maybe you can. Actually, the nickname the Redbeard came from when I went to school up in Seattle. When I did my 3D program. And my wife, it was a 9-month program, and my wife stayed here in Utah because we just bought this house, and she had a full-time job, and she was going to be the one supporting us. So, because you ain't going to dye it pink, there's always marijuana, and I've heard marijuana works, but again, I have tried marijuana oil, where you are supposed to rub it on the back of your neck, and it doesn't do anything. Nothing. Not even a buzz. So, but anyways, I was in school where the red beard came from, and my wife stayed here, and so I said to her, I am going to not shave or cut my hair for the 9 weeks that I'm up there, or the 9 months I'm up there. I've got to show a picture. These are great pictures. And so when I was at school, I just grew my hair out. I didn't cut my beard. And everyone, by the end, everyone was calling me Redbeard. Let's see if I can find any of these pictures. They're gross. Like, when I mean I didn't cut my beard, is like I didn't trim it, I didn't maintain it, I did nothing. And it was just gross. Let's see if I can find any of these. My hair was super cool, though. Let's appreciate that. I'm going to find that. You guys will be... No, I'm not. I'm not going to find it. Never mind. I'm not going to waste time. Anyways, I had really long hair. Crazy long hair. CBD pills. Would that work? I've tried a gummy once, and it didn't do anything. Anyways, at school, everyone started calling me the Redbeard, and so it just stuck. Before I was the Redbeard, I've had many nicknames, and many different online personalities. Before I was the Redbeard, I was... Ninjabot? And I don't know where that came from, but I was Ninjabot for a few years. And then before that, when I was in high school, I was Junior Fatty Duck. And the story of that nickname is really dumb, and I'm not going to tell it, because it serves no point, and there was no reason behind the nickname. But I was Junior Fatty Duck through all of middle school until high school, when I met which is now wife, but girlfriend there. She's like, "Hi, my name's Matt. Some people call me Junior Fatty Duck." And she's like, "No, that's not happening." And it ended right then and there, which I'm grateful for. We're all grateful for the age of Junior Fatty Duck to be over. The mustache. Nice. You see, and this is the thing, like, Sadius, like, to do marijuana, which I'm not super opposed to, but this is, for a guy like me to do it, would be a bit of a change in my life, because I don't drink, I don't smoke. I'd never have done like drugs, even in high school. Like, I honestly don't know where I would find them. So it would be a big change. But again, like, I'm literally willing to try anything because of it. Yes, Fatty Duck. Yes, and Carla, my wife, is the reason it stopped, and it's so good. I had a drawing that I would put everywhere of the Junior Fatty Duck. It was horrible. What a horrible nickname. I might try it. It's going to be harder to get in Utah, as it's not legal here. But I may not. We're still trying some other things, but I'm not opposed to it. I think we were all called that in 10th grade for a while, actually. noise canceling is throwing some sick beats. See, it's good for something.
Mm-hmm. Now that I've got this leg, I'm just gonna mirror it over. Actually, let's do a not gonna do a dynamo wish. I'm gonna mirror this over, get that the way it should. Rename to Leggy 2. Do a mirror. And I'm obviously not on the x-axis at all when I'm doing this. So that's why it's doing it over there. I just don't care to change it. Called you John? Well, that's obviously... Actually, the first time I saw your picture, I was like, she could totally be John. In high school, I used to, because I'm horrible at remembering names. Like, horrible at remembering names. And so I would make up names for people that I was too shy to say, hey, I don't know your name, but I'm still going to talk to you anyways. So I made up names for people. So I had Almond, Yellow, B, these are all nicknames, Whiskers, the long one, the chin. I mean, there's so many nicknames that I had for people. Mayonnaise. Gonzo. and they're not like, these are not mean nicknames. Like, they're not done out of malice. They were just nicknames that, I mean, the guy wore a blue shirt every single day. Every single day that I knew him, he wore a blue shirt. So he turned into Gonzo. Hey, thanks for stopping by, Stadius. I'll let you know if the marijuana is an idea, but right now, posture. John Adams. It all makes sense now. Because you were the second president. The Intuos tablets are great. I used a bamboo for like 7 years. I probably still have it somewhere that I've kept. It's this old little white thing that I've just, yes, obviously the second president. The Intuos tablets are great. You can check out, if you want something that has a display on it and you don't want to fork out a ton of dough for the Wacom stuff, Monoprice actually has some decent tablets, and they're pretty comparable to what Wacom comes out with. Obviously, it's not going to be nearly as good, but it's not going to suck either. So for the price, I mean, for $70, you get a nice medium-sized tablet, or even $50, I think you get a nice medium-sized tablet. Leggy, 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 blondie, 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 blondie. Ooh. Yeah, those, I've heard great things about the Cintiq Pros. Like, I haven't tested one. I went to a... I was at a... Dealey, where, Dealey. I was at some convention that Wacom was showing off those things, but they were all down at the time, so I couldn't actually go and test it out. But I've heard cool things about them. They do seem a little bit overpriced, again, because it's an all-in-one computer, and once it's outdated forever. Is like my real only drawback on them. But they also have great, you know, they're better than any tablet out there for sketching, most likely. Yeah, the Intuos is great. I went from a Bamboo to an Intuos myself, actually. And had that for another 2 years or 3 years until I got a Cintiq. And mainly got that because I was just so used to working on, you know, this is what we use at work, so it was a good investment to get in. Hello, Walking Dead. Oh, is the Cintiq Pro just the monitor? I thought the Cintiq Pro was an all-in-one machine. Like, but if it's just the monitor, then that's great. Hi Matt, can you convert a 2D image into a 3D image? Sure. That's what I'm doing. So I guess I could toss up the concept that I sketched out for this real quick. Texture, import. Computer gonna crash now. It crashed. Yes, let's do a save. Saving is the best. Come on, computer. So yeah, so this is all coming from this sketch that I did. Oh, yeah. We'll quickly just fill that white around it. Kill the opacity a little bit. And then turn off body samples. So it's all kind of coming from this concept. It's not perfectly that. It's close to it, but I'm finding things that I like and some things that I don't like. So it's obviously gonna go through it some changes.
hey, Andy. So that's the process that I'm doing, and the main things I'm focusing on, again, are big, long shapes, big, long lines of action that go through. Like, you're seeing it's kind of breaking here, so I'll fix that. Some twists, some, you know, the idea that it's he's moving, there's movement in it. So that's kind of what we're doing today, that we've been doing for the past couple of weeks. You know, Walking Dead, I actually, you know, I don't really do that too often. I'm a busy dude, and, you know, between full-time work and what I'm trying to do with my own personal projects, I've stopped taking on freelance jobs, so I'm not the guy to do it, to help you out with it, unfortunately. But I'm sure John Adams could probably help you out. Yeah, I used to do a lot of freelance, and I ended up, like, working my butt off for things that I wasn't super animated about, and so I decided that I'm not having fun with that, so I'd rather pick and choose the projects that I want to do, and mainly it's just my own stuff, my own, you know, working on tutorials or working on my own maquettes or my own animated projects, and I've been a lot happier since I've decided to do that. Definitely a lot happier. What's my email? Yes, John Adams. My email is just my name at gmail.com. I trust John Adams. Okay, let's do these legs, these knees. Do I recommend to study sculpting with other artists drawing, even when you can draw or character design? Let's see if I understand that. Do I recommend to study sculpting with other artists drawing, even when you can draw or character design? If I understand that question correctly, I recommend every sculpting artist should draw. They should draw every day for 20 minutes, even if you suck, even if you think you suck, right? I obviously, like, my drawing skills, I'm not a horrible artist, but I'm not great. I know that. I'm not going to get a job as a 2D artist anywhere. But by studying 2D, especially 2D animation, that pluses my skills and my knowledge on what I can do better in 3D. And just understanding things on a different level, on more of a graphic level, instead of a you know, where I'm competing with shapes all around. I can break down these competing shapes into simple shapes. and kind of translate these 2D ideas into 3D. So I recommend you study both. Study sculpting, do sculpting nights with friends, do drawing nights. They're highly beneficial. Sculpting with people, sculpting, drawing with people, especially finding a group that's better than you, is so beneficial, because it really just, they'll help you find your faults, and you'll just be plus all around in the end. At least that's my thoughts on it.
Hey, Matt Thorber, I wanted to thank you for your tutorials. Hey, thank you. I made a sitting... Oh, let's see this. Oh, dude! That's awesome! Oh, man, she turned out great. Yeah, Xenos Fighter, that's killer, man. Did you use fiber mesh for the hair? Or did you use something else? Yeah, the Nine Old Men books are great. Yeah, that's a real nice. Yeah, it doesn't look like fiber mesh. Like, I was going to say, those are some really clean lines for fiber mesh. I think I talked about that, how I'm starting to train, not with X-Gen at the moment, but I'll be working with Ontrix, I believe, and kind of testing that out, and the GHM2 or whatever it's called, I don't know. I'll be doing some of that for work in the next couple of weeks. So I'm stoked to kind of learn some new skills with those. You're starting your first job on Monday. Sweet, man. That is awesome. Congratulations. How does it feel? Living the dream, man. That's awesome. You've been great. Yeah, I bet, man. That is awesome. Release. Let's turn that music back on. If it still works. Yeah, of course, man. That's cool. You'll have to share when you can. We've got some cool stuff that we're announcing at GDC this year. I don't think we're talking about too much from Chair specifically, but from Epic Games, we've got a pretty big showing there because of the Unreal Engine and whatnot, so.
got some real cool stuff coming up. Can we have a moment of silence for the Z Modeler brush? As that's completely changed my workflow. I love the Z Modeler brush so much. This is a fun trick if you guys didn't know about this. So the crease, when you add in creases, you know, you see these dotted lines around things. It's going to keep that edge. It's going to keep that edge really sharp, you know, no matter how high you go up, and it just doesn't have a super great appeal to it. So let's step back. Ooh, let's put those creases back. So what you can do is change the tolerance or the crease level where it will uncrease. If you change it to 3 or 2, after 2 subdivisions, it'll take off that crease and be nice and smooth, which gives a little bit more of a beveled-ish look to it, which is cool. I'm surprised we've gotten so far into this stream and nobody's mentioned anything about conspiracy theories. Kind of disappointed in you guys.
Five AM.
Yeah, go to bed. Thanks for coming by, Dark and Grim. Yeah, so this should be finished up pretty soon. I'll probably have it done by our next stream, and so we could just focus on like maybe a speed sculpt or like a chick or something. I don't know. Maybe we'll just sculpt John Adams because that seems to be the subject tonight. Something fun. Yeah, it was Z Modeler. That Z Modeler brush, I add in loops all the time. Just to get a little bit more definition. Just, you know, now when I subdivide this up, oh, yeah. It's going to already start having these arcs in there that I want. And the feet. You know, trying to get some roundness to the bottom of the toes. But yeah, I do that all the time, especially when I'm doing block-ins with just primitives, which is normally how I do things instead of Z-spheres now, is I'll block it in really, really low with maybe like... Here, I'll show you. Let's do a save. Save. Let's load up. So for my female, the Miss February, like I do a block in with just, this is my block in, just super, super simple. You know, there's one loop in all of these, you know, and then I'm busy doing lizard. I saw that. And so once I have this, I'll just go in with the Z modeler brush, and start doing insert loops, and then I'll be able to, you know, just kind of control these edges just a little bit more, so I can pull out, you know, get hints of this muscle, and just do little things. So not, I don't go over too crazy with it, but just enough that when I round thing, you know, subdivide it up, it's going to keep that shape, and bring it into that. Yeah. I do have a Gumroad for beginners if you're looking to kind of learn some techniques. So check it out. I have a beginner one, and then more of an advanced, intermediate to advanced, and then a more advanced teaching some of the new techniques of ZBrush with that female biker chick. Oh boy. Oh, and then the Pixelogic Classroom is killer as well. I mean, that's where I've learned a ton of, you know, all of Joseph Druss' videos that he puts out are great, great resources as well. What would be the ultimate goal of character? Print of the girl character or of this character? This end goal is to print. You know, that's why I'm modeling it this way instead of doing it in a T pose or a neutral pose. I'm doing it this way because it is going to be for print, and I wanted to get the feel for the overall gesture as I'm developing the, you know, the personality of the character. Notice that, you know, I'm keeping things really simple in their designs. As he's going to be small, you know, he's going to be about the size of the pen, about 6 inches. So that's the main goal of getting this printable, and just to have a cool character design that's a little bit fun, a little bit mischievous. So, can you have the same camera in KeyShot and ZBrush with the bridge? I don't think you can. Like you set a camera in ZBrush and have that like the same viewpoint. I don't think you can. KeyShot and ZBrush have, you know, their cameras are just different. ZBrush is a little bit more augmented in their perspective, like you can adjust their perspectives. And KeyShot is more of like a HDR or like a SLR, an SLR camera settings. So they're different cameras, but it's not hard to change your viewport. See what I'm doing. get some fat knuckles here. I probably will push these toes together. Maybe not. Actually, probably won't push those toes together, as they're going to be pretty thick for the print. Yeah, I believe that ZBrush has more of like a two and a half D. Is that the technical term for it, Kyle? Where it's a little bit augmented in the way that they do their 3D masses. It's not like a true 3D. That's kind of how they can handle so many polys that you're sculpting on and manipulating. But maybe I'm completely wrong. Yeah, you could actually do render passes in KeyShot. With the new KeyShot 6. And maybe you have to have the Pro, like, which is a couple $100 more than the standard one. That's looking like poop. But you can, and if you don't, then you can kind of fake it by doing your render passes by just setting up like different rendering one light at a time, you know, doing it manually. Yeah, 2.5D. That's what I said. Was I right about that? Page not found. The link has the sorry in it, and it's not full enough. There it is. Yeah, it doesn't use the GPU. It's all CPU. Same with KeyShot. KeyShot's all CPU. Yeah, the depth of field is way nice. But can you have ZBrush matte caps in KeyShot? Yes, you can have ZBrush matte caps in KeyShot. The version that KeyShot came out with, that's for ZBrush, it will actually retain the matte cap that you have. So if I had this matte cap on and sent it to KeyShot, it would actually retain the matte cap. Let's do the test. Let's save first. Let's save for crying out loud. My goodness. So if I was going to take this, it's got a matte cap on it, and I could just do render external to KeyShot, hit BPR, my key shot's gonna open up. Maybe. Let's try that again. So then I just send it the key shot, and it keeps that mat cap because I have it on. And I believe I use key shot pro because I like the idea of being able to do animations and turntables, and I do all that stuff. I love key shot. Key shot's great. Again, I have a really cool render that I just did from key shot that I can't share. But it's gonna be, when I can share it, boy, y'all be like, oh, that's a cool render. Yeah, Pro's great. It just has a few extra features in it that really, I think, make it worth it. I mean, you can get all that stuff similarly, but it's just, you have to do it by hand, which isn't fun. I think I need to take a little break, like a 5-minute break. We've got about an hour left. Let's take a 5-minute break, and then I'm going to be back and we can talk about all the fun stuff. We'll finish this leg off and then, you know, do the other leg too. Get the legs in a good spot tonight. Okay, I will be back in 5 minutos. Just like this image says.
And we're back.
Yes. Why am I part-time? I'm a gigolo. Not great, but it pays the bills. I like these questions tonight, though. They're good questions. I'm just trying to get these toes in a decent spot before I mirror them. Hey Matt, how do you get such clean edges and creases? For example, like your Disney Infinity figures, Han Solo's collar and vest and whatnot. That's fine, Mr. Solo. I think my son stole him from me. He did. Let's grab one of the characters I did anyways. Okay, so the key For like clean, she's one of the characters I did. Let's actually just pull up an image. Actually, it's way easier. Why don't we just do that? Mr. Solo. Here we go. So Han Solo, one of the characters I made, so to get like these clean edges here, it's a combination like on the face. Like here, all this stuff. I'm using the JA cut brush. The Jack cut brush. I can't remember what it's called. I use this brush right here. This is a brush that a fellow artist at Disney made, and it is awesome. It is the best brush in the world. And so that's what I use to reinforce clean lines, because it's really, really crisp and clean. Do you see it here on the knuckles, here on the legs? But for this stuff, like around his collar, I do a combination of Z Modeler and let's do a demo of that. Let's give this guy a color. So if I was going to give this guy a color, let's give this guy a tank top, okay? Not a collar, because he's got no neck, but we'll give him a tank top. So what I quickly do is I mask off the section that's gonna be the surface area of the tank top. So like this. This is gonna be his tank top. And then I do an extract. So I run an extract on it under subtools, extract. See what the extract does. Let's try again. Oh, is this multiple subdivisions? Okay, this is multiple subdivisions. We'll just undo all this. Make sure it doesn't have any subdivisions. For some reason, it's not doing the extract. Oh. Maybe it is doing the extract. We just can't see it. This is so weird. I've never had this happen before. Let's try doing it. Extract. Accept. What does it do for me? Oh man, it's huge. That's why you can't see it. Okay. Delete. I wonder if this is just tiny in there. Extract. Yeah, this thing's gotta be just tiny. Anyways, I would run an extract, clean up the polys, manually, and then do a crease and uncrease. So like for his collar, I don't know what's going on right now. I bet I have the scale really, really off. And that's what's going on. Either it's really big or it's really small. Something's going on though. So yeah, question Brooke Z brush. So let's try this instead, where sometimes I'll use this topology brush, where I will go in and I'll draw the exact topology that I want, which I think I actually did that with Mr. Solo here, because he's got a very clean collar. So I draw the topology that I want, like so, and anytime you get a quad, it'll brush it out. I change my intensity down to 0, because that will determine the thickness. I'll just tap to accept it. So this will give me a flat plane. So I would do that for the whole shirt. I would draw out the topology, quad it out, tap to accept, and then take this and, you know, delete. Let's duplicate this real quick. Delete hidden. So I just have this plane, and then I've got my original here. My original here, which I'm just going to step out because I don't want to lose, you know, my subdivisions. So go to this, then I go to my Z modeler brush, hover over a face. Normally I'll do a full extrude, and that's going to give me the thickness and the clean topology that I want. And then I'll just simply take those edges, crease, you know, increase it, set the tolerance to 3. And then when I subdivide up, as soon as I hit 3 or 4 subdivisions, it's going to uncrease everything. And then you're going to get that really clean edge look. And I try not, if I ever modify this, I go back to the basic subdivision and manually, I mean, I'm just pulling points. And that's how you get, the only way to get really clean topology like this, the only really way to get clean topology like this is to do it that way, and just manually pull parts. Like this whole curve, if you look in, these actually curve from the inside to the outside, so it does this, and it's all just manually pushing and pulling points. But it gets really, really clean results fairly quickly. You know, now he's got a nice pad there that's really clean. So that's how I would do that. Get a puff out.
Ah!
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of tedious a little bit, but you get really clean lines out of it. And I love some clean lines. I mean, that's why I always work from low to high like I do. Is I just very picky about cleanliness. I hate mushy stuff. But yeah, other than that, when I'm sculpting like organic stuff and I want clean lines, I just use that that J cup brush. It's beautiful. I'm using it right now. I like it a lot more than the damn standard because it's just cleaner. It just seems to have a clean edge on it. You put a little bit of a lazy mouse on it, and you're gonna have yourself a good day. Wow. watch. I'm going to redo this whole foot because I don't like it. Anyways, not today. Make these toes a little bit more of a call out. Maybe I do want them touching. Who knows? Who knows? They're just not really, they're not much of a statement right now. They're just kind of dealies. Maybe like puff them out a little bit, maybe give them a stronger crease. Ugh, I don't like what I did there. Let's take that crease out. I'll probably revisit these toes as I'm putting, when I start putting in like these little claws. I want claws on his toes. I think that'd be cool. Maybe there's a piercing on one. Let's focus on this face a little bit too. And I wish I could say to you guys that my computer is not going to be so laggy next week because my new computer will be here. But now I have no idea when or if it'll ever be here. So that's unfortunate. The idea is I'm actually going to have these things overlap the eyelids. But I'm kind of staying away from it until I get the higher poly sculpt and zero mesh it. So then I can push them in and there's actually going to be overlapping there instead of dynameshing them together. And kind of losing that. What computer did I decide on? So I'm building my own computer, is what I decided. And I bought all the parts for it. It's the computer I got. Well, the computer that I got the computer that I ordered was It's the Intel 7700 chip with a 1080 NVIDIA graphics card, 64 gigs of RAM. I mean, this thing is a beast. It's gonna be a beast. I think I'm gonna decide to wait a little bit and order the new AMD processor that's an 8-core for $500. It just seems like long term that's gonna be better for KeyShot and for ZBrush. And so all the parts were supposed to be delivered today, Artist Future, believe it or not. And as I was gone, we were gone from the house, it said the package was delivered, but when we got home, there was no package to be found. So I think, and we've had reports in our neighborhood of people stealing packages. And I was so worried about this. My wife was home all day. But we had to go. It was my kids' wrestling meet. And so right now I have no computer that was delivered. Like, tons of stuff is gone. So hopefully Amazon's going to help me out. I hope. Yeah, I hope that too. I mean, the thing is, like, it's like 7 packages filled with, you know, each package has tons of stuff in it. I mean, Amazon's pretty good, so I'm sure everything's gonna be okay. I mean, everything, even if whatever happens, like, everything's gonna be okay. Even if it sucks for a little while, so. Yeah, I think I'm going to request it to be signed. I mean, if they're going to send another thing, like, it's just like the biggest bummer in the world to me right now. So that happened, like, right before I started my stream, by the way, so I've calmed down, the anxiety's a little bit gone. It's gonna return tomorrow, and I probably won't sleep tonight because I'm just gonna be so bugged about it. But it is what it is, and nothing I can do right now, so I'm trying not to worry about it. Oh, no worry, Marky Mark. Yeah, I did actually start this in Z-Spheres many moons ago. It started off kind of looking like, let's find it, like this, when it was adaptive skin with limbs and stuff. But yeah, it's all I posted all out. I don't normally start it like this, but just wanted to try it out. Ooh. Put those teeth back in there. her to give some feeling to this. Nice. And then after that, like, I've just been sculpting after, I kind of figured out the pose. I started sculpting from Dynamesh. Yeah. It just slowly built up. I mean, real, real simple shapes. How long have I been in the industry, and when did I get my first gig? Does KeyShot work better with AMD processors? That I'm not sure. It. I'll answer the KeyShot question first. As far as the AMD processors go, I'm not sure. I know that KeyShot works better with more cores because it's CPU based. So. I know that their the AMD graphics cards aren't as well supported as NVIDIA, for sure, but I haven't read anywhere that they're not supported. And then I've been in the industry, I've been working in the industry for 6 years. Before that, I was a graphic designer, I'd made anything from websites to business cards, to logos, to brochures. You know, I taught myself coding, I coded websites for a while, did a bunch of that stuff. Until I decided I really wanted to get into the industry. So I've been an actual character artist for 5 years of the 6 years, and it's been great. I've been fortunate enough to work on some really cool projects and some really great teams. And kind of be able to do what I love. Where did I get my first gig? Ooh, this is a great one. I got my first gig at this company called React Games. And I did everything for them. I made their website. ReactGames.com. I think I still... let's check. ReactGames.com. I think they still... Yep. So I made that... they still use the website. So I made that forum years ago. Yeah. Nakita, it is a big learning curve, especially coming from graphic design, but it's awesome. I love it. And the thing is, I love graphic design too. Like, I could have done graphic design forever. It was awesome. But it's still just had that drive of wanting to do something else. Am I entirely self-taught? No. As far as graphic design goes, I was. Graphic design, I was a self-taught graphic designer. I was hired in... I went to a graphic design studio and said, I will do anything you guys want to be hired. I'll be your janitor. I just want to be here. I want to learn the industry. I want to learn how graphic design. And so I went in, and so they hired me in customer service, where I dealt with people yelling and being upset most of the time. And then in the meantime, at nights I was teaching myself graphic design by watching tutorials, and I did all these crazy tutorials just to learn it myself. And then I would go in the next day and I would talk to the graphic designers and say, okay, help me get better. What's wrong with this? And they would give me honest critiques and they would say, you suck. And that was good. I needed to hear that. And then they said, but this is where you could get better. And so they'd show me some techniques and some design principles. And so after a little while about doing that, a few months of doing that, I got kind of good. And they hired me on as a graphic designer shortly after. So I did that for many years. Hold on a second. I've got to check something out. As I heard a bang, gotta check on the kids. I'll be right back. Just right back. Everything's okay. Sorry, my almost three-year-old, kind of falls out of his bed every now and then. So, making sure he's okay. He was fine. He didn't fall out this time. Hey, I'm doing good. So I'm not entirely self-taught as a 3D artist. I went up and I did a school that was in Seattle. I live in Utah. I'm from Utah. And so I did this school up in Seattle. It was a 9-month all-you-can-eat 3D program. 5 days a week, 8 to 5 every day. And it was awesome. It was so great. Kind of immerse myself in and just think about nothing but 3D. We learned Maya, 3D Studio Max, ZBrush. We learned Maya and ZBrush together. Hey, cool. So yeah, so it was just like downtown, like Pioneer Square. If you're familiar with that area. I was just talking about Heya, that's where I started was graphic design. as a graphic designer for 5 years, doing all sorts of fun graphic design stuff. So that school was great. It kind of imploded on itself, though. So this semester after I left, they closed up shop as the owner went crazy and all the students kind of revolted. So it's really sad because I thought it was like a killer program. Oh, I don't do graphic design anymore. Unfortunately, just something that I don't have a passion for anymore. And I'm so out of practice, actually. Like, to do a logo, I would have to change my mindset just because there's a certain mindset and, like, even a trend to logos that you have to kind of keep up with. And I don't keep up with graphic design anymore, so even if I did do it, I'm not the guy that you should look for. Got a lot of places that do graphic design in Seattle. They've got some good studios out there. I did freelance for one when I was up there for a little bit. I can't remember what it's called. What it was called, though. I did very little freelance when I was in Seattle to just focus on school. I kind of figured out a long time ago, like when I was teaching myself graphic design, that I have a very specific way of learning, and it's immersive and can't be interrupted, or I just can't focus. Like, that's the way I learn. Like, I tried doing a university, and like, we sat down in that class, my first multimedia class, and they told us that we wouldn't be touching 3D for the first year. And I was like, okay, see ya, suckers. And I left, and then I got out and I taught myself graphic design and then got into 3D later, and it worked out great. So that maybe not be the right way for everyone. I know that it's not the right way for everyone. But it certainly worked out for me, and that's just my way of learning. Yeah, there's some great graphic designers on DeviantArt. Also, if you go to like logopond.com, a lot of graphic designers are on there and they freelance that are really, really good. Oh, yeah. No problem. What is Logopond? Logopond is... Let me make sure it still exists.
Logopond.com. Logopond.com is a website for graphic designers by graphic designers. It is a ranking system. It's like, it's just like Instagram for logo designers, where designers post up logos that they've done. Other designers like them, like give them rankings of like a. And so it basically comes, it's like the best of the best graphic designers are there. And they critique each other, and there's a whole community there. I might even have a site there. Let's see if I do. Search. Let's see. It's been forever since I've been on here. Okay. NinjaBot. Nope. Or Brand 88. Nope. Yeah, it's been so long. I'm sure I had something here. Many years ago. Anyways, there's some great logos on there. The one, you can find out kind of the style that you like, and two, you can find artists that you like, and they will, you could get them, you could hire them on to work for you and actually build a logo for you. So it's just kind of cool. So do you animate these models as well, or is this is it a primarily character design? This is primarily just character design. This is for to be 3D printed. Like, that's the end goal of this, is I'll actually print it out. And you know, have it. So if it was to be animated, I'd go at a different approach. It looks like my time, I'm supposed to be ending right now. I started a couple minutes late, so I'll stay on for like, let's say 5-10 more minutes. And then I'll get off. I don't want to go over my time too much. But if you guys have any more questions, feel free to ask. Question, BB Art. Question, I'm doing some quick UV master work, and when I come back from working on a clone, every subtool looks like as if it went into display properties and flipped each one. Ooh, that's weird. Kingsley, you have any idea on that? They may be reversed already before you've even gone into UV Master. So you could try going here to display properties and make sure double's not turned on. That way you'll see if it is turned on, the most likely thing is that they're flipped already. And if they're not, then man, I have no idea. What is my favorite project that I've worked on so far? Oh, that's a tough one. Disney Infinity was great. I love Disney Infinity. I love Disney, you know, growing up loving Disney. My favorite character that I did for them, I mean, the new project that I'm working on is pretty great. But I can't talk about that yet.
But I think from the last one that I did is probably the Moana figure that never got released. This was actually a lot of fun. Let's pull this on over. This is in my portfolio. This was probably one of my favorites too, as it was different from anything that I've done. Well, not really necessarily different, but it was a lot bigger. And I got to work on this with one of my favorite illustrators, Brett Bean. He came up with a design and I sculpted it. You know, we kind of did a team effort to do this and then get it mass produced, did a short run of it. And it just turned out great. Like, the quality is impeccable. They really picked up all the details of my sculpt. Like, Brett's design was awesome. Like, it was one of those weird things where we kind of had a mind meld where I just understood his language when he would give critiques. And so there wasn't a ton of back and forth. Like, he would say, well, do this. And it was like a rough explanation. And then I just understood it and would kind of hit exactly with what he wanted. And so he's awesome. And it just turned out really nice. We had the head animator come to my college and show us a presentation on Moana. Was that Hiram? Hiram Osmond that did that? Did someone say mind meld? No! John! I'm dying. Hiram Osmond, he's great. He's a super good animator. He's one of the lead animators on Moana, and he came. I actually got to sit down and talk with him when I was making the Moana sculpt and kind of figure out, you know, this is before they had a lot of, it was just storyboards at that time. And, yeah, he was probably Hiram. He doesn't have any defining features, but super nice guy, kind of tall, skinny, dark hair. Anyways, he sat down with me for a little while and talked with me about Moana before, you know, when the movie was just in the storyboard. So I got to sit down and kind of pick his brain about who her what her personality is, and how I could, you know, show that in the sculpt if he had any ideas. And so we got to sit down and he, you know, explained all these great theories about who Moana is, what she's trying to find out. Try to be like who? What is she really doing? And like, what do we want to show in that, in the sculpt or in the figure? And it was really, really cool, really inspiring to be able to work with someone on that level and that cared so much about that as well. You know, when we've worked on other characters, they don't really care too much. They're like, we just want a cool pose. I'm like, well, that's not gonna make a cool pose if you don't know who the character is. So it was fun, especially doing with something. Yeah, tall, lanky guy. Yeah, that's him. Super nice guy. Did he also do Olaf? Olaf, not Olaf. Olaf. Did he talk about that at all? Yeah, he was awesome. Yeah, that was him then. Yeah, Hiram's great. It was really cool to be able to connect with him. And the Moana was probably my favorite character. I also like Fought a lot. The art director wanted to kind of make her more slender and kind of cheeky, kind of a like a princess, like a girly, like a girly girl. They wanted to make her a girly girl. Kind of these lovey eyes, these
you know, thinner all around, and I fought really, really hard to not let that happen. And in the end, I got it. I got what I wanted. And she turned out great, and I thought she reflected Moana really well, and just kind of a shame that it didn't ever see the light of day, because it, you know, everything closed up before, in mid-manufacturing of her. The evolution of the chicken is great. I love that Alan Tudyk did the voice of the chicken. Just so he could be in the movie. Yeah, let's see how everything is looking together. This might be my stopping point, as I can't take up all the time. I didn't get to work in house with the Disney feature team. It was, you know, we worked in our studio in Salt Lake. But I've been out to the Disney feature studio several times. You know, we kind of develop relationships with the artists there. You know, as you look up to them, you know, I looked up to them. You know, that those guys set the bar, so we're honestly is just trying to hit what they've already created and kind of found. So okay, I think I'm gonna call it a night. Let's just do last save. Thanks for everyone for joining me. I'm going to close up. You guys are great. Thanks for calming me down. Make sure you follow PixLogic Kingsley on Twitch. And thanks Squid Tank. So yeah, I'll have this guy finished for next week, and show you how I do the keys, and we'll just do keys, and then we'll just play around and maybe make something cool. So thanks for coming by, guys. You guys are excellent. Your guys are awesome. And follow Kyle. PixLogic Kyle. Yeah, thanks, BBR. I'll let you know how that goes next week. If I'm in tears, you'll know how it goes. Okay, good night, everyone.